Good morning. So I slept at the, what is it, Baymont Inn? In the parking lot. So that's my new thing I found. When you're in a car or a truck, it's good just to sleep at a hotel. You blend in. I parked next to a camper van.
Turn right onto Nevada 225 North.
You blend in, and there's not cars driving through the parking lot all night like at Walmart. So I don't know if I'll ever stay at Walmart again. And there's plenty of hotels, and they're
continue
always
for 190 miles.
But we are leaving Elko. It is 5:35 in the morning. So I looked up what's on the roads. It's Mormon crickets, a plague of Mormon crickets. Tens of millions of Mormon crickets they have in the state of Nevada. So that's what I saw last June also when I was in Nevada. But yeah, it's nasty. They smell. They're on the car. I was going to wash them here, but I got to drive through it going north. So once I get to Idaho, I'm going to look for a car wash, I think, and get them off. It's just, oh, it's nasty. So basically, the Nevada Department of Transportation is using snow plows to clear them off the roads in places. Well, they need to do that where I'm going. You can't even see the lines on the road in one spot. They're so bad. But, yeah, Elko's a nice town. I really like it. It's 58 degrees right now. The high today here is only 80. Wow. And it's partly cloudy, it looks like. Oh my gosh. So we have 189 miles to the interstate, I-84, and Idaho, and then we go to Boise, so we're gonna go to Mountain Home on this highway. It should be a nice drive. I've never done this road, which I can't believe again, and you go through some cool mountain areas. So hopefully there's no deer this morning. Wow, so you start going, when I came into town last night, you're going down this steep hill and you start going up quick. Should be pretty. Better now though. I slept a good probably 5 hours in the parking lot. So I went into Maverick this morning, went to the bathroom, and they have pizza already. I almost bought some, and I'm like, I do not need pizza at 5:30 in the morning. It was really tempting though. I didn't buy anything. I was gonna get some Def, but it's a brand I never heard of. So I really like to stick to the good brand. This was, to me, this was a no-name brand. And I got enough to get home, technically. But I'll look in Idaho when I get gas again. See if they have the good Def. What a day yesterday. Make sure you watch the previous video. My plan is to title it Praying to Baby Jesus to Get Off the Mountain Alive. Because that's what I was literally doing. You'll hear me in the video. It was scary, 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 scary. If you've seen it, you will understand. It was the Jarbidge Wilderness. I'm not sure I would ever come in from the south or leave from the south again. From the north, it's not bad. And I was trying to figure out a road to get across and stay in Idaho for the most part. And I think I found a way, but it would be very confusing. And who knows the condition of the road, because it's way remote. I can't imagine hardly any cars going. You got to make lots of turns. And so I honestly don't think it's possible. Maybe if you have a Jeep, but I wouldn't try it in the truck. But I wouldn't try it alone either. Oh, Nevada is beautiful. Yeah, Mormon crickets are disgusting. They had plagues of them when the Oregon Trail settlers came through and settled in the Salt Lake City area. They basically eat all the vegetation, crops, plants, grass. So, I can't remember what year it was, but just to give you an idea of how widespread they are, I want to say it was either 10 years ago or 20 years ago when they had a really bad infestation. The Mormon crickets covered 10 million acres in Nevada. 10 million acres. That must be like the whole northern half of the state. I don't know if they can survive in the southern half because there's nothing to eat. So, yeah, you'll see them in the camera this morning when we start driving over them. So that's my new thing to do when I can't find a camping spot. I'm gonna camp in hotel parking lots. Not camp, but sleep in hotel parking lots. And there's always a gas station nearby. So like this morning, I drove, half a mile to Maverick and used the restroom. Yeah, I was tempted to not go to Elko and get diesel, but if I would have driven north to the nearest gas station, I would have had, best estimate was 50 mile range left in my fuel. So worst case, it could have been less or I run out of fuel. So I didn't want to take that risk. Plus I wanted to film this part too. So it worked out. And it sounds like our medical emergency is over. Not too bad, I don't think. I'll hear more today, but as of late last night, the thinking was everything's okay at this point. And watch the previous video if you want to hear more. But, I'll let you know when I hear more. I'm pretty sure everything's good though. When you get old, people go to the emergency room a lot for things and it turns out to be nothing. So, crossing my fingers that it wasn't really anything. This morning is once I get to I-84 in Idaho, there'll be tons of gas stations with food. This is Adobe Summit, elevation 6,549 feet. And there are no trees on this mountaintop. Too hot and dry. But I'm gonna save it for when I come out here. I mean, I don't want to push my luck after yesterday. I need to have more time when I do this next drive. I want to do it. So this Jarbidge Wilderness, it's called, has, I think it's like half a dozen peaks over 10,000 feet, and not one of them is visible from the highway, or any highway. That's what it said, because it's so far back from the highway. I didn't quite understand that, but it's a beautiful area. It really is. What I would do, I think, if I ever went to Jarbidge, I would go from the north. And if I ever wanted to camp in the Jarbidge Mountains, I would go from the south. I would never do that 20% grade again, though, going into Jarbidge. That was scary. That was scary going up. I can't imagine going down it. You'll see. And if you watched that previous video, you'll have seen. But I'm gonna try and be quiet this morning and let you all drink your coffee and enjoy beautiful Nevada. And I hope you're having an awesome day. Going 55 now, but I was worried about hitting deer last night. plus the Mormon crickets on the road make it like ice, I read. Most of the rain is to my east again, tiny bit to the south and a tiny bit to the west, and nothing to the north right now, so we might not see any more rain on this trip, which I wish we would see more rain to get the bug off the car. The Mormon crickets, their little guts and body parts all over the underside of the car. Ugh. Gives me the heebie-jeebies again just for thinking about it. It's so gross. So they invaded Elko in June, and they even got inside your house somehow sometimes. I don't know how that happened. I think they fly. I'm pretty sure they could fly. So they probably went down chimneys and stuff. Oh, so nasty. I couldn't live here. I could not live anywhere with Mormon crickets. I just decided. There's no known defense, like spray, you know, or nothing. And if I remember correctly, they're not technically crickets. Um, because they kind of look like crickets. That's why they're called Mormon crickets. Yeah, research them. They're disgusting. Highway, no problem, but I am kind of kind of glad that I get to film the whole thing from Elko. So, a little happy. I think I'm happy about how it worked out. Wow, so there's a house back there. They must have 15, 20 cars on the property. It makes you wonder, like, do they even have keys for all those still? And do they even run? Lots of trucks. I mean, they didn't look junked or abandoned. That's why I wonder. Then I wonder how many people live in that house. It was a really old stone house. Oh, look at the fog ahead and in the mountains. So we're going 60 now, and speed limit's still 70. So right now, I'm getting in the, well, I was getting right around 30 miles per gallon, going flat there. Is it bad? I've been averaging about 26 for the whole trip. 26 miles per gallon. Wow, I gotta turn the climate control off. It is too chilly. It's down to 51. Goes off to the left and makes a loop and rejoins Highway 225, which we're on now, farther up the road. Someday I'll have to check it out, but I really want to see this highway today. I think this highway has the more scenic stuff. Miles. windshield washer fluid in the reservoir. Get me home. Wilderness, the majority of it is like 20-25 miles from the highway, and the Bear Creek Pass is the name of the pass I did at 8,500 feet. That's on the western side of the wilderness too, I want to say. The highest peaks are even east of that. So maybe that's what they meant when I read the article on the internet, that you can't see any of the 10,000 foot plus peaks from the highway. We'll see though, when I get close to where I came out, I will see what I can see. Oh, this is beautiful in here. We're starting to get into canyons and everything. Switched over to Pacific from AT&T, so I don't know. Somehow I wonder if I was getting a signal from Verizon, somehow like 50 miles away. It was weird. Though that town, when it had the gold rush and all the miners were there. starting to wonder if the truck is wrong. I'm starting to wonder if Nevada changed it so they're same time as the Pacific time zone because they don't follow daylight savings time anymore. That's what I'm starting to wonder. And the truck is basically wrong. It might be 6:15. Went to sleep last night in the truck. At one point I woke up and I don't know how I had my foot, but it had fallen asleep, and then the rest of the night was fine. I took the keys out of my pocket because initially I was afraid of you know you're careful how you lie on the seat because you don't want to set the alarm off, you know, from hitting the button on the keys. So finally I was like, you know what, I just put the keys in the console, then I could turn, I could lie on my left side or my right side in the seat. It's actually pretty comfortable in the truck when you put the seat all the way back. 190. Rush hour will be over by the time I get there, so that's good. It'll probably be around 11:30, possibly even noon if I go, go slow or really slow. Mormon crickets and other bugs like them are nature's lawnmower, I guess. I mean, their only purpose is to eat grass and stuff. truck that passed me a while back. White Ford. Yep. Garbage is 47 miles to the right. This is where I came out of the mountain, so they must have plowed the road. Or the majority of the Mormon crickets were alive still, and they went off the road. That is so bizarre. I know I wasn't imagining that. They're all over the truck. Wow. So the cell phone tower right in front of me here on the left, that's AT&T. Yeah, you can't see the 10,000 foot plus peaks from this highway. Oh, that's wild. I know I wasn't imagining that. Wonder if they're on the highway at night or the evening for heat, and then eventually it cools off and they get off the highway to go eat in the grass. Oh, that's wild. The truck in Elko, it looks like. I was concerned about running over them again. And then the truck just getting dirty, you know, a second time. there's the lake, Wild Horse State Park Lake. Entrance to the road I was on, and maybe that wasn't where I got onto this highway, because this is not the lake I thought it was, I don't think. So I need to look for another cell phone tower along the road. cover. Okay, this is another jar bridge way to get into the right coming up. Wild Horse State Park Recreation Area. So, I was right. I did go in that first entrance. Yeah, so, unless I see another Wild Horse State Park, must have plowed the road. It was so dark out, I couldn't see anything except the road is the problem. Oh, window's getting filthy. So the road here looks wet. It almost looks like they did plow it here because there's no other reason for the road to be wet except for buck guts. Oh my gosh. Do I dare? Let's do it. Wow, there's trailers everywhere, not one car. I swear, people just park their trailer and leave. They're just tying up spaces. I hate it. Elko to Humboldt National Forest. Thanks for watching.